Hi, everybody. Welcome again to another OIT Quick Tip. And today I'm joined by one of our Academic Technology Service Directors, Jennifer Culver. She's the ATSD in the Simmons School of Education and Human Development. And she's got something really cool to show us today called Playposit. So, Jennifer, what is Playposit all about?
Playposit is a video tool that will let you insert questions and discussions into videos that you find on the internet, like YouTube. Playposit is different than Kaltura because with Kaltura, you have to create the video yourself to be able to put quizzes in it. But with Playposit, you can find them anywhere.
Cool.
Here's a quick example.
Hello. Welcome to Energy Conservation Incorporated.
Thank you.
So this is a video I found on YouTube. And here you can see where the questions are showing up and guiding the student through the process.
What do you think are your greatest strengths?
We can skip to different questions.
It sounds like your fifth grade teacher.
And this is a forum discussion, and you can see here that students are able to actually provide audio discussion if they'd like. They can put in images, they can do all sorts of things as part of their reply. So to create a Playposit video, you start in Canvas, and you'll find it after you create an assignment. Once you name your assignment, when we scroll down here and look for submission type, we're going to choose external tool, and then we click find, and we look for Playposit version 2. This one right here.
Okay.
And then your own Playposit account will show up. Because we're still piloting with Playposit this year, if you want an account, all you have to do is email me, jlculver@smu.edu, and I will set up an account for you. And then you'll see the screen and you'll be able to get started. Your Playposit dashboard appears right here in this assignment space, and we start creating a Playposit assignment by creating a bulb. Playposit calls their videos bulbs. We can enter a video here from YouTube. And let's just find a TED Talk that we can put in because those are really popular.
There's no such thing as a perfect writer.
All we have to do is copy the link right here and come back over to Playposit. And paste the link. And Playposit will find it for you. And you click add. And Playposit now will guide you through the question-making process. Now, Playposit runs in a similar way to Kaltura, where you haven't really downloaded the YouTube video. Playposit is just talking to YouTube, and it's embedding the video from YouTube. So if something happens to that YouTube video, then Playposit will not be able to keep using it anymore if it turns private or if it goes away. So if you're using YouTube for copyrighted material, and then it goes away, Playposit won't be able to keep it.
Always have to be cognizant of that.
But as the video plays, when you have a moment where you'd like to insert a moment of interaction for the student, all you do is click here on the grid.
You roll out of bed and
add a question, and you can see all the types of questions that Playposit offers. You've got the standard multiple choice one. You've got the free response. The reflective pause gives you, as the instructor, the chance to say something before a scene appears in front of the video. So if you wanted your students to notice something in particular, that would be a good way to jump in and tell them what you want them to look for. Or if they just saw something that was really important and you wanted to reinforce that, a pause would be a great way to stop and ask them to think about what they just saw, or to have you point out something that maybe they wouldn't see. Polling surveys are surveys that when the students participate in them, they'll see all the other answers that appear in their classroom that's assigned. We also have fill in the blank. You can embed a website and you can have discussion forums. So if I want to create a poll and ask a question, look, as here I can also add this as audio. I can talk through Playposit. I can add my own images to my questions if I want to reinforce something. I can even insert a link to a website if I want them to look at something. And I can change elements of text if I would like to as well. So you have a lot of options here.
Yeah.
As we add answer options, and save. And now you've got your question saved. And
8 meters across your upper,
that's all we have to do is come in. If you already kind of know in the videos where you want to ask things, you can jump ahead and stop where you want to stop. You can also trim your video. So if you don't want them to see certain things at the beginning or the end, you can always change that as well.
Okay.
So here's an example of a reflective pause. And when you're finished,
because soil is air rich in carbon dioxide,
and get all the way to the end, you have a chance to preview your work. You have choices on how you'd like to share the work. Here's a link so that even though you're constructing Playposit as an assignment in Canvas, Canvas is not the only place that can show your Playposits. So here's a link that you can send to other people if you'd like them to do the work outside of Canvas. You can embed it into a website. And you can decide over here if you're using these kinds of links for professional learning or in other situations and you don't want it to look as if it's graded, you can always say, I'm just using this as an example, so I don't want it to be graded. And notice if I change my mind and I do want it graded, then I'll use that option right there. We'll come up to the top and give it a title. I have some more formatting pieces I can choose right here about whether or not people can rewind or skip questions. I usually don't want them to do that, but I might want to let them retake it if they want to retake it. And then I can hit save and finish. So I'm still connected to that assignment in Canvas. And here's where I can decide if this is what I want my students to do. And if I do, then I'm just going to set the link. And then I'm going to decide if I want my students to do it self-paced or if I want to do a broadcast. This is another interesting feature that's unique to Playposit. Self-paced is what we typically assign for homework, yeah, where they take the video and they go through it on their own devices. They answer the questions. They come into class in a flipped learning model kind of approach. A live broadcast, though, is a little bit different. A live broadcast would be showing the video inside your classroom in real time. Oh. If it's a live broadcast, then what Playposit will do is it will only show the video on the instructor's computer, so there aren't a bunch of videos starting and stopping throughout the room.
Okay.
And the questions that you set will pop up on the student computers as it's going.
Oh, wow.
So you can use it in real time as well. We'll make this one set self-paced. And then we set the link. So once you save, when you come back to your original Canvas assignment, you'll see a link right here that is the link to Playposit. You can finish setting up your assignment the way you normally would and hit save and publish. On the student end, what the students see is the Playposit assignment inside of Canvas. So Canvas is talking to your gradebook, and it will put in the questions if you have them set, if you have multiple choice kinds of questions that they can grade. And it will keep track of all the analytics for you. And so all students have to do is play and answer whatever questions that you've set up inside of the Playposit video. They don't have to type their names or make an account or anything else. There you go. And it looks just like that.
Wow. That's pretty easy. And the greatest part about it that I've noticed is, you don't have to actually produce the entire video like in Kaltura. You can just bring anything in from YouTube. So one question real quick I had, can it work with other cloud video services other than YouTube?
It can. It works pretty well with Vimeo.
Okay.
And it works pretty well with a couple of other sites too. There are some sites that require authentication. I know that in SMU we have some rights to some films and things like that. And those don't work with Playposit because of the authentication that it requires. So things that are behind passwords, Playposit cannot get to on its own.
Okay. Great. Well, what else do you have to show, if anything, there?
As an instructor, if I want to come back and look at the assignment, all I have to do is hit monitor. And here's what Playposit shows me.
Oh, okay.
Shows me all of the questions as a whole. And then if we had other students, then when we went farther down, it would go student by student and let us know how all of our students did.
All right. Awesome. And like you said, once this is all done, especially with multiple choice, it's already in your gradebook, graded and ready to go.
Yep.
Wow. That's great. this is a pilot program, so they do need to contact you,
yes.
Right? Okay. We'll put your address there on the screen so we can get the word out and make sure folks know how to utilize this really, really helpful system. And I thank you so much for showing it to me today.
Great. Thanks for having me over.
All right. No problem. And go ahead and feel free to go to our website, smu.edu/OIT, for any more information, and give Jennifer a line if you want to use Playposit. Thanks for joining us.